Hi everyone, my name's Jason. I'm a research physicist here at the lab. I'm going to talk to you about dance parties, secret handshakes, and fusion. So we're going to start on the left-hand side of these slides and talk to you about something that seems very unrelated to fusion. So imagine you're at this super cool dance party where the rule is that you need to perform a secret handshake in order to successfully dance with a partner. And here I've just given three examples of some kind of interesting handshakes. And let's assume that the one with the green tick is the one that you have to do. But the catch is that you're not told in advance which one of these handshakes you're supposed to do. And so it turns out in this population of people who go to this dance club, only 2/3 of them actually correctly guess the correct handshake. And so under this random guesses kind of line there, you see only 2/3 of the people are dancing. 1/3 of them look kind of lonely, not doing that much. However, there's this bouncer at the club. He's like, wow, this is really sad. I'm just going to tell everyone in advance what the handshake is. And so now everybody at this party is now able to like successfully dance because they know what the correct handshake is. One challenge that you might think about this is other dance clubs might try to emulate this strategy and they might secretly like tell people going into this dance club like the wrong handshake. And so therefore not as many people are able to dance properly. Okay, what has this got to do with fusion? So let's move to the right hand side. Well, typical fusion reaction that we use for power takes two isotopes of hydrogen and puts them together and you get energy out. And I'm going to claim that you need like a special handshake to do this as well. So it turns out that for the specific reactions we're looking at, we need the nuclei of the fuel to point in the correct direction. So you need the right handshake. And so here I'm showing on the second line on the right that the green tick is like the correct orientation of the nuclei for your fusion fuel that you need. However, if you don't do anything in advance and you just kind of use like a normal gas for your fusion fuel, only 2/3 of the fuel will actually be eligible for fusion and 1/3 will be kind of lonely like those lonely dancers. And so one thing that I'm working on is basically figuring out how to prepare the fuel in advance such that when the two isotopes of hydrogen meet each other, they do the correct handshake and you get a much higher rate of fusion reactions in your plasma. And one big challenge of this is actually figuring out how to prevent the fusion fuel from actually losing its spin, which we call the spin is the orientation of the nuclei while it's in the plasma. And that would prevent the fuel from doing the correct handshake. So yeah, thanks very much.